mercy and love because you share of God's Spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时灵性在他体内。 若灵性已离开，他立刻就死亡。灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上，我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他？还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识他了。 我们以为肉体真我而不知它原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与罪恶。为了持此色身，享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性。 而我们已不是仅限于此肉身，我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰，因我们的灵性与老是一体，我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而，现在人们都失去了这些品性。 亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3. What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal. B. The divine mantra. C. The symbolic seal. A. The first treasure. The heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience, which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, "Who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way?" 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, "Heaven is 108,000 miles away." These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away. But with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经？天，你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝：一玄关，二口诀，三合同。 第一宝玄关，玄关玄妙莫测之门，玄关点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心，它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。 2. 生死之门户，玄关是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰：“谁能出不由谱？何莫由斯道也？”3. 通天大陆佛经云：“西天108,000里，此是譬喻，亦成佛事不义之始。” 因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师今已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点。
The main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher, your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, a. the eyes, b. the ears, c. the mouth, d. the nose, e. the navel, f. the vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. B. eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. C. mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. D. nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee, etc. E. navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类。二、由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三、由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类。四、由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇、蜜蜂之类。五、由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六、由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点。
In the Bible, Matthew 13:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God's sanction and commandment. The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God's spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one, thereby enlightening you with God's spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上帝在约翰对他的门徒说：“我用水给你们施洗，表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命。” 那盏佛灯代表上帝老，在点到之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以相助，从佛灯引来一条经指向你们的玄关，然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时。 上帝一一的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。6.
I have the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal.
6. 释迦牟尼佛云无有正法掩藏此语，暗示玄关之底。Be
the second treasure, the divine mantra 1. You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio.
1. 本文1大士因缘，降生河北，原为大德龙之染场总经理兼厂长，因积劳成疾，经诊断为三期肺病，幸遇孙兰芳老先生劝说求道，蒙活佛老师慈悲显化，病体好转，知恩报恩，信守诺言，一心报恩了愿，舍身办道。2. 抛家舍业，立身行道。 跟随师尊、师母修办道，民国30年领受天命位点传师，积极开创道务。3. 立志开荒，到传蓬莱、景尊师母往东南方开荒训示，开创台湾道务。4. 关考连年，艰辛闯关，50年代关考连年，师母忧心弟子安危。 惦念道务前景，近日祈求老中喜考免灾，众生一切罪过错，原由他老一人承担，加上韩公审着果断坚毅不拔之心志，终能以一克服难关。5. 坚定信心，再度扬帆，创办育幼院、光明仁爱之家及筹建天元佛院，并带领各位前人开创日本、南洋、美国等道务。6. 红展道务。 遍及五州73年忏悔班，师母指示未来道务要韩公带领前人辈继续提灯笼，照亮九州，使众生早日回头。76年初，韩公以道务前途为重，派齐玉庸、陈洪真两位前人代表参与一贯道总会申请立案筹备工作，于77年3月5日成立中华民国一贯道总会。 海内外道亲共尊韩公未道长，自从政府宣布一贯道合法之后，台湾各地道务如雨后春笋，是农工商各得其位，各地道务一家兴盛，人才一波波成长茁壮，是白羊史上之盛世。此后，许多点传师到各地开荒，遍及五大洲。韩公常以五恩天。 帝君亲师鼓励大家，尤其对孝敬父母、忠于国家、热爱社会、博施济众等事业，不遗余力，而公所慈悲领导之大道场人才济济，将来必为道场、社会、国家培育栋梁。7. 回馈社会。 贡献国家。三、结语了愿成道，名垂千古。84年正月念六日子时，韩公在天元佛院感恩楼中圆满成道，含笑归天，令闻者悲泣，哀哲人甚深勇士矣。回顾韩公一生，自奉圣简，博爱助人，宽宏恕人，克己服人，培德度人，传道成人，毕生奉行师尊师母遗志，传承天命，大公无私，见道成道，戮力于普度众生之圣业，时时刻刻抱守违法忘趋，为道殉身之大无畏精神，60余年如一日，可称在世之孔子，一代之宗师，实为后学之典范，众生之导航。白水老人语录二一前言，承接白水老人语录一中，对性理心法三宝书甚之确知，在语录二里，老前人更剖析修道培德、办道济世之真意，使后学们更能明了自己的使命担当，立德、立言、立功，创三不朽。一正文，七孝德未先，万善根源。八回光返照，真忏真悔。九时时感恩，日日天堂。十明理修身，处事有道。十一培德养慧，坚志持恒。十二办道真义，立命了命，普度众生。三结语，道在圣传，修在己，肯定道之尊贵，更应济师志，成师德，立身行道，使智化娑婆世界为莲花帮。